Hey guys, so I read a quote the other day in the news, of all places, that was talking about God, and it was from this Bible scholar, and it was a fantastic quote, and I want to read it to you. It's by Carrie Niehoff. No idea who that is, but it says, "I have to remind myself that mostly my desire to skip, pull away, and do my own thing on my own schedule isn't solitude, it's isolation. While solitude is a gift from God, isolation is a tool of the enemy. And there's no faster way to render a community ineffective than to isolate its members." And that just speaks to me because I know that my natural inclination, I think many of our natural inclination, is whenever things, when you're struggling with things, you want to pull away. You want to pull back. You want to, you don't want to be there in the struggle or be there in the uncertainty. And so I just want to encourage you, like that we as the church are meant to be a body made up of many parts. And Paul talks about this. He says, like that as the church, we have to give special recognition to the parts that are maybe not as flattering, right? And that being said, it's because we need to realize that we're in this together. And whenever we realize that we're one body and we're one, we all our members are one, then we can start celebrating our successes together as one. And we can start mourning our losses together as one. But if we don't open up to one another, this is where the discipleship aspect comes in, then we will never have the bond between the different parts of our body. The bond comes from discipleship and from spending the time with people. And so I just want to encourage you. I know that my wife and I personally, we went to a church for over a year. And during that time, at the very end of our time there, it was about 15 months in, and they had a celebration. And the celebration was because they were moving from the smaller building into a bigger building on the same lot that they had been building since long before we even got there. And it was a big celebration. It's a huge party. And my wife looked at me afterwards and she said, "I feel like I just went to somebody else's party. And like I'm happy for them and everything, but it's their celebration. It wasn't us." And it wasn't that we didn't want to connect with people, but we were so isolated. And sometimes the church can do that. And we don't want to be an isolated people. We have to make the effort to reach out to people. And sometimes that comes from our leadership. Sometimes it comes from the people that sit in the pew that are members of the church, but they refuse to kind of get up and do something. Everyone was meant to be made into disciples. You look at the Great Commission, "Go ye therefore and make disciples." And guess what those disciples have to do if they're going to do everything that Jesus told them and commanded them to do? They're going to go and make disciples. And they're going to go and make disciples. And they're going to go and make disciples. So you, as a Christian, as a church member, it's your job to make disciples. And so that's the breath of the church. That's the heartbeat of the church because it connects us together to where we can all flow together. So I challenge you, if you're not connected, like maybe you go to church but you're not connected, it's time to make some connections. If you've been going to church for years and you feel fine, but you know that you're not doing anything, it's time to make connections. Thanks for taking a minute.